afternoon, everybody. Time for your WoofOfBricks.com update. Once again, I am Jim, and this is where we talk about Lego investing and reselling. So before we get into part two of Common Mistakes, I would humbly like to ask you to like and subscribe to this channel. It really helps out the channel, and I greatly appreciate it. Now let's dive in. This video is going to be part two of Common Mistakes. We did have part one earlier, maybe a week ago. I will put that link below. If you like this one, make sure you check out the first one. And the objective of these videos, of course, is to help you become a better reseller. So let's get into it. So another common mistake is overlooking non-franchise sets, right? And let me share a little story with you. So earlier in the year, there was a gentleman who I kind of knew at work. He was somebody that I would chat with on the phone occasionally, work-related. Well, word got back to him that I deal with Lego. And funny thing was, he dealt with Lego too. And he really didn't know this, that there was this whole reselling world of Lego. He just started buying Legos and flipping it and things of that sort. So we started talking and I said, so, you know, I'm into Lego. What do you like to flip? And he says, oh, definitely Star Wars. How about you? And I said, well, personally, I like Friends. And he's like, Friends? What? And I was like, yeah, I actually have a YouTube channel. You may want to check it out. I mean, it's kind of cool, right? And so he called me back a couple days later. And he's like, whoa. He's like, I had no idea. He said, I really thought Star Wars or some of the, you know, franchise sets were the way to go. He said, Friends is actually quite the honey hole that not a lot of people know about. And I'm like, yeah, I know. That's why I do it. So don't ever discount non-franchise sets. As a matter of fact, I would probably point you to non-franchise sets first before you go to franchise sets, right? So right now, Mandalorian is big, and there's a ton of winners in the Mandalorian theme, right? But you may want to look into Duplo. There's not a lot of people that are into Duplo. Again, I spent more on Duplo this year than I have on any other Lego set, and this is the most I spent on Duplo ever. So it's kind of crazy, but I'm happy I made the decision because there's not a lot of people out there reselling it. Well, I should say not as much as some of the franchise sets or the staples like architecture, right? So I'm able to kind of navigate in and out rather quickly. While everybody's over here, I'm over here and I have some breathing room and I'm able to do what I need to build my business better. Selling too early. There are a ton of people that like to sell too early in October and they like to lower the price. You don't want to be those people. Why? Because you're trying to get 200-300% return on your investment. You're not trying to make a couple nickels here or a couple nickels there. You're trying to build your business, and selling too early is not the best way to do it. You want to remain steady in your decision-making process, and if you have a target, a good target to sell a Lego set, then you need to stick with that. You shouldn't let the moment of Q4 get to you and maybe create a fog. If you have a plan laid out, you should have a very competitive price that you put on your Lego set, and you should stick to it. Pricing sets too high. You also don't want to set high prices on your Lego sets, because here's the thing, man, and I know everybody enjoys Lego. I enjoy Lego. But here's the thing to keep in mind. These are not bars of gold that you're selling, all right? This is a product. This is a product that hundreds of other people are probably selling too, right? So you don't want to have an Ewok village at $900 the first year after it retired. It's not going to sell. You want to stay competitive. You want to sell that set so you can bring in revenue to buy more sets, and then you're going to rinse and repeat. I do know a few people that have emotional attachments to some Lego sets, and because of that, they have it super high, like maybe a Tower Bridge at like $800. Sorry, Tower Bridge ain't going for $800 today, folks. But you want to stay competitive, because here's the deal. If you are setting a high price on it, it's not going to sell, and you're leaving money on the shelf, so you can't bring in more revenue so you could buy more sets. Not buying from physical retailers. Here's the thing. For the longest time, I rarely went into a big box retail place. Big mistake. I like to walk in there. It is a bit of market research, right? You kind of have your boots on the ground. You're seeing what's popular, what you know, what set is sold out, what set has 20 units of them on the shelf, you really want to do your research. And I promise you, you will have gained some wisdom and more experience if you do that. There's also some promos, of course, right? You just don't want to go to the big box stores whenever there's clearance, although that is a great opportunity, right? But Target, it seems like for the last 2 years, Target has been just giving out the buy $50, get a $10 gift card. You could only do that so many times on Target.com, right? I mean, if you want to maximize that offer as best as you can, you're going to want to go into the store. You're going to want to hit the Target next to your house. You're going to want to hit the Target next to your work if there is one. You're going to want to hit multiple Targets, and it will just benefit you and your business. You never want to underestimate value opportunities. So there may be a lot of clearance deals at Target or Walmart especially, and that's great. But let me tell you, man, I guarantee you everybody that's watching this has probably missed an opportunity when it comes to gift with purchase. I know I have. So I want to challenge everybody, just don't buy the 20% off Lego set on Amazon. You know, try and put together some research, which we're going to be talking about next, and you know, see how you could double, triple, even quadruple stack your discounts, including gift with purchase at the Lego store or Lego shop at home. There are times throughout the year where you could do a quadruple stack whenever it comes to a gift with purchase, whenever it comes to your VIP points, whenever it comes to credit card offers, right? And they do have different gift with purchases. I think one time, I forget what I bought. I think I bought $125 worth of stuff at the Lego store, right? But because one of them was Harry Potter, I got the Book of Monsters, and then I also got the Charles Dickens gift with purchase too last year. And that was great. I practically bought those sets for nothing if you add the gift with purchases to that. So always make sure you're not underestimating value opportunity. So failing to research, and I'm going to use sourcing from eBay as an example. I think there's an article on wolfofbricks.com, and I've said I was going to do a video on sourcing from eBay. I promise I'm going to do that video. I'm going to make sure I do it no later than the end of January, tops, I promise. But, you know, there will be times that you may come across some people or an organization that's able to get you a lot of Lego sets, maybe an unlimited quantity amount, at a decent discount, maybe 20, 25%, and that'll be attractive to you, right? Because you don't always want to do the Amazon limit quantity 20 or sometimes limit quantity 3, and then you add it to your cart, you go ahead and buy it, and then you have to wait 2 weeks, right, for you to be able to buy that again. And this is a set that's retiring, and that quantity may not be available, right? So you want to go ahead and do your research. And I've said this in the past, that time you're spending to do research, that will be paid back to you literally monetarily. You will be making money and you will be making revenue from doing that. You won't see it that instant, but it will happen over the next 12 months. That's it, my friends. Hope you enjoyed part one and part two. If you have any questions, I'd love to hear them down in the comments. I'd be happy to answer them. Again, please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Jim with wolfofbricks.com. Always go out there and get it.